We're back with our panel of Fil-Am leaders, Lloyda Nicolás-Lewis with Fil-Ams for Biden, attorney Marvin Lim, and nurse and doctor of education, Medel Pagiran. Thank you all for joining us once again. Now, let me start things off with this question to you, Lloyda. We know the youth vote is very important in every election. What's your sense of Filipino-American youth engagement this time around?
Yes, for the Filipino-Americans, millennials, Gen X, Y, Z, I think they are more involved now than 2008 or 2016 because the immigration question of their friends, the DACAs, those who came here and grew up here before they turned 18, are of their friends and they are illegal. And this president had erased or has repealed that executive order. So for me, I think since they have many friends who are TNT, they should be more involved. But they're also Americans.
I think there is a great deal of energy, particularly here down in Georgia, as the new, or at least presumptive, state representative elect for my district. I've obviously heard from many Filipino Americans. I would say a good half of them are in the 30 and under, certainly the millennial category. So that is very exciting. Because when we talk about the major issues of the day, a lot of them have long-term implications. So all of the youth, including Filipino Americans, are really fighting for their future. So I'm very happy to see that there is this a greater energy, arguably, than before among Filipino American youth.
You know, as we've seen, there's actually quite an anti-Trump movement within the Republican Party, and Republican leaders like former Ohio Governor John Kasich and business leader Meg Whitman were included in Monday's DNC program. Medel, you are a registered Republican, as we've mentioned. Tell us why you find yourself voting across the aisle in this election.
Okay, I'm voting for Biden because I want a leader who relies on science and evidence and not just on feelings. Mm-hmm. I want a president who respects the content experts because I'm in the healthcare. I want them to respect the scientists who can give advice in a more organized manner in order to address these health issues. That's my main reason as a healthcare provider. I also want a leader who will take care of the health of the LGBT population, especially mm-hmm. the transgenders. And also the youth, I want a president who will address the educational needs of our vulnerable population, especially the Fil-Ams, okay, mm-hmm. to get free education, no matter their income level is or what their demographic background is. We need them because they are gonna be the next generation of leaders in our country.
Mm-hmm. Well, sounds like you have some key points that have really defined how you're voting in this election. I want to toss back to Lloyda. You know, for voters who might not be like Medel, who haven't made up their mind just yet, what can you say to those who are still on the fence about the vice president, the former vice president?
Yes. May I just add that in the Filipino-American community, we have youth Filipino-Americans for Biden. And so I'd like you to join us. For those who are still on the fence, will it be Trump? Will it be Biden? I have to ask you one question. Are you for our values of speaking the truth, being honest? Would you like a liar in chief who every time he opens his mouth, he's lying? Or would you like Biden in his 37 years of public service has really been there for the people? Do you want a president who's been a traitor, whose ally is Putin? And anything that Putin says, he believes. Or do you want somebody like Joe Biden, who's respected by the international community and who has shown he is for the United States? He will champion the United States, but he is in cooperation with the other free world. Do you want a president, as Medel has said, who only believes in himself, so arrogant, and you know, I alone can fix it? Or do you want a president like Joe Biden, who is humble, who listens to experts?
Wonderful. Well, I want to thank you for your time, Marvin, Medel, and Lloyda. It's a pleasure to hear from your different perspectives.